Hello, Clairlea Park Presbyterian Church, friends and loved ones. My name is Pastor Kevin Livingston, and I'm delighted that you're tuning in for this time of informal Christmas carols and special music that Karen Gonzalez, our music director, and I have been putting together over the last little while. We'll just have a variety of songs that you can sing, as well as songs that you can listen to. So without further ado, why don't I begin with a word of prayer, and then let's sing together. Our gracious God, we thank you that in this season as we approach Christmas, we of all people should be ready to sing your praise and to sing with great joy because Jesus, our Savior, is coming into this world. So Lord, today as we gather together by virtue of YouTube and the internet, help us, Lord, in our own homes and our own places where we are to give you our thankful, joyful praise. In Jesus' name, amen. On with the show.
Their flocks by night, all seated on the ground. The angel of the Lord came down, and glory shone around. Fear not, said he, for mighty dread had seized their troubled mind. Glad tidings of great joy I bring to you, all humankind. Born of David's line, a Savior who is Christ the Lord, and this shall be the sign. The heavenly babe you there shall find, to human view displayed, all meanly wrapped in swathing bands and in a manger laid. The seraph and forthright
And now Helen Blair leads us in singing the hymn, Angels We Have Heard on High.
Gift is given.
Now let's listen to Patricia Lamb as she plays an instrumental on the piano, Mary, Did You Know?
Thank you.
Friends, now we're going to hear Jonah Huezo. And Jonah is friends of Karen Gonzalez and especially her daughter Rosalie. And we'll be hearing Jonah sing The Little Drummer Boy. Well, friends, Pastor Kevin here. I hope you're enjoying your time of Christmas carols and hearing special music for the season. I just wanted to share a special story that I heard this week and want to pass it on to you. I shared this with the prayer group at church, but I wanted everybody to hear it. We have friends named Jerry and Dorothy Key. They live down in Birmingham, Alabama. We've traveled with them in the past. And we got an email from them this week, and they talk about something very special that happened to them. Let me read their letter. It says, "We are sharing this story with a few good friends. God is great. Dorothy and I," that's Jerry's wife, "Dorothy and I have been working with a family through our church who live in Gibbs Village, which is a government housing project, a poor area. We've worked with the family for the last 2 to 3 years. We think we had not seen the family since December 2019 due to COVID. We were having difficulty trying to determine what to do for this family this Christmas because of COVID. We thought of several reasons why we should skip this year and pick it up next year. but we could not let it go. We just continued to feel that we needed to do something for this family this year. So after praying about what to do, it came to us that we would give the mom a gift card so she could shop for her kids and get some Christmas gifts. She has an 11-year-old son and a 4-year-old daughter. This would minimize our contact with the family. So we purchased the gift card. I tried to get in touch with another church member who visits the neighborhood every Sunday so he could drop the card off, but I was unable to contact him. We tried to call before we arrived, but we couldn't get an answer. So we immediately drove to the family's home to give the card to the mom. I think God wanted us to deliver the card in person. I know now that that is what God intended. When we arrived, we put on our masks and knocked on the door. We could see someone peeking through the blinds. Then the door opened, and there stood the 11-year-old son. The first words out of his mouth were, "I have been praying that you would come back this year, and I prayed just last night for you to come." And then in a loud and excited voice, he said, "And here you are." Jerry goes on to say, as the old saying goes, "You could have knocked us over with a feather." We will never forget those four words. His prayer was answered. We had returned. We visited for a short period and then we left. But when we got back to the car, we cried. We had just experienced the works of God, and we had played our small part. Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to be the answer to someone's prayers. Thank you, Lord, for the testimony of your love for us and others through answered prayers. Please give us the opportunity and vision to recognize additional situations where we can share your love. Amen. That was Jerry's prayer, and he signed off his letter like this: "God is great, Jerry and Dorothy. P.S., he says, "I think our motto in 2021 and our goal will be, and here you are, and here we are." Where will we be needed in 2021? Where can we do God's work and share his love next year? Wow. What a story. What a beautiful story of God answering the prayers of that little boy and of Jerry and Dorothy being the answer to that prayer, even though they didn't know it at the time. Oh, friends, may God give us that same perspective on life that God gave to Jerry and Dorothy, that we can trust God and believe in the power of prayer, and that sometimes we can be the answers to someone else's prayer too. Let's have some more music together.
Stay by my
Karen Gonzalez has written a special musical piece for this Christmas season. It's called A Baby Born, and Jonah will sing it for us now. Friends, this is a treat. Helen Blair will now sing for us, O Holy Night.
Oh.
Christmas is a time for many emotions. At times it can be solemn and thoughtful. At other times it can be celebratory and joyful. For this final song that we're going to do, we're going to sing one of those joyful songs, Go Tell It on the Mountain. So let's sing with enthusiasm. And after that final song, we'll close with a prayer.
Thank you.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. While shepherds kept their watching, or silent flocks by night, behold, throughout the heavens there shone a holy light. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. The shepherds feared and trembled when low above the earth rang out the angel chorus that hailed our Savior's birth. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Down in a lowly manger, the humble Christ was born. And God sent us salvation that blessed Christmas morn. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
Well, friends, that about wraps it up. It's certainly been a strange year, 2020, and I sure don't want to repeat it again, do you? But it has been good. There have been things that God has taught us about what it means to be a community, and even when we can't gather together physically and face to face, we know there is that strong bond given to us by the power of God's Spirit, that we are one people, one body, one fellowship in Jesus Christ. So let's have a prayer together. Gracious God, thank you for the gift of music, music that lifts our spirits, music that creates memories of time long ago, music, Lord, that helps us understand a little more about who you are, your character, your love for us, especially as it's been made known to us in Jesus, your Son, whom you sent to the world so many years ago in Bethlehem. Lord, in these days, help us to draw close to you and to one another, and may we communicate and share your love, even as that letter from Jerry and Dorothy reminded us to do. Thank you, God, that you are at work in our lives and at work in our church in surprising ways. We pray now that you would send us with your peace into the rest of this day and through the rest of this season. In Christ's name, amen. Well, friends, be sure to gather together tonight at 7 o'clock. That's Sunday, December the 20th. We're going to be having a live online Zoom congregational gathering. So please wear your ugly sweater or some festive garb. And I look forward to seeing you. The link to that Zoom meeting has been sent to everyone's email. I look forward to seeing you soon. Bye-bye.